God. Luke chapter number 19, verses 1 through 4. And I'm going to try my best to say what the Lord had me to say and get out of the way. And Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. And behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among the publicans, and he was rich. And he sought to see, catch this now, and he sought, he became a seeker. He sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press, because he was little of stature. And he ran before. Oh, there's a lot of theology there. And he ran before and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way, church. He ran before, Pastor, and climbed up, Pastor, to see Jesus, for he was to pass that way. I want to challenge everybody who's under the sound of my voice. This is what I come to preach to somebody. If you can change your attitude, you can change your altitude. If you can change your mental disposition, you can change to a higher level in grace. Touch your neighbor and say, if you change your attitude, you can change your altitude. Wake up the person behind you to tell them, if you can change your attitude, you can change your altitude. Father, we love you and we thank you. We bless you right now, Lord God. Use me, Lord God, like you never used me before. In the name of Jesus, touch your people. Open the ears of the listeners right now. Let them hear you and not me. In Jesus' name I pray. God bless you. Good morning, and please be seated for right now. I feel like preaching. Amen. Change your attitude, mama. Change your altitude. Let me start off by saying this to all of my people of low disposition. Ezekiel chapter number 16, verses 4 and 5 reads something somber like this. And as for thy nativity, in the day thou was born, thy navel was not cut, neither was thou washed in water to supple thee. Thou was not salted at all, nor swaddled at all. My God. None I pitied thee to do any of these things unto thee, to have compassion upon thee, but was cast out in the open field to the loathing of thy person in the day that you were born. Lord, there are some of us who have wearied ourselves into the sanctuary today who understands the synergy of this text. It seems like since the day we were born, we haven't had a break. If it's not one thing, it is the other. Since the day we've been born, we've had constant problems. As a matter of fact, Job declares that a man that's born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Perhaps your fathers may have left your mothers when you were a child, or perhaps your mom was somewhat promiscuous, or some things happened that when you were a child that left a permanent scar on your soul. Some people told you that you'd never be anything, you'd never be nothing, but like Joseph told his brothers, he thought evil against me, but God is going to make it good. Amen. Somebody say that with me. God's going to make it good. God will get the glory out of your suffering and out of your pain and out of your misery. God is going to get it. And we know that all work together for the good of them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. Why? Because our past do not define me, church. My past define me. Your past define me. What was going on in your situations way back then, it don't define who you are. Well, what's going on even right now in your personal life don't define you right now. Your past don't define you. And your present don't define you. And glory to God, if I ever step out there, your present don't define you. I mean, your future don't define you. What defines you is your relationship in Christ. I mean, even though I may have some situations that I'm still working on, I have some stuff, some flaws and some character issues and some personal shortcomings. Please be patient with me, church. God is not finished with me yet. Somebody here with me and who's not perfect. Is there anybody in here that's not perfect? Just wave your hand. God is still working on me. I still got some stuff that he's still working on. It do not define me because of my flaws. Glory to God, because the word, glory to God, told me that if any man.
Amen.
If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature, and all things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. So even though, glory to God, I still may have trouble in some situations, and glory to God, I may not walk the walk that you think I need to walk and to talk the way you think I need to talk. I'm glad that I'm not what I used to be, so I'm praising God. I'm leaning on the everlasting Lord, and glory to God, you just keep praying for me and stop talking about me and let God work on me and I'll reach to your level somewhere, somehow. Oh, yeah. See, because the church has a problem of people who may not be where they are right now, and so you have a tendency of playing the little studio God or the quasi God and start judging people because of where they are right now. But God, remember where you was 20 years ago. And what you did in the back of a 1957 Chevy. Oh, glory to God. Why are you judging? This new generation. God, remember the level of grace that he brought you up out of a pit. Oh, glory to God. Oh, they don't like my preaching. Jesus. Right side of the track, touch that devil and tell him you're a liar. I Oh my God!
Mercy!
My God, my God! And in this text, we find this young man named Zacchaeus. He is going through what I call an identity crisis. The book says, and behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among the publicans, and he was richer. You must understand that the word Zacchaeus throws me for a bit. Oh, glory to God. In the Hebrew, it means pure, clean, and righteous one. He was a Jew by birth. But what he was doing was anything but righteous. Oh, his name, glory to God, means he was a good man. But what he was doing was anything but good. He was robbing from his own people, extorting his own people. Oh, glory to God, there was an identity crisis. Such as it is in the church today, when I was studying this word, the church as in its entirety, Bishop, is going through an identity crisis. We don't know who we are. Oh, glory to God. We don't really know who we are. For the church means those who are separated. It means ones who have been separated, who have come apart from this world system. But all you see really is a whole lot of world in the church. Oh, glory to God. Now anything is happening in the church that's starting to bring all kind of stuff in the church. Things that God ain't got nothing to do with. It's all in the church. You don't know what you're going to see. You got something you're supposed to go into worship, but all you see is first class entertainment. Going on with you right now. The Holy Ghost come told me to tell you.
sword. And you almost had to do cartwheels and flips before we get into the praise. But if you can't find nothing to praise God about, you must be out of your mind.
Silver Springs, I got mad respect for you, but I'm not letting
said, and he ran before, and he climbed up into a sycamore tree. Why? For he was past to kill me. The path that way.
That way.
Oh my God. The tax collector. Get this. He's too short to see over the crack.
Come to me.
But his desire is so great that he exercised creativity. In today's vernacular, he got slick. He knew how to negotiate and to navigate through those who would hinder him. Oh, y'all ain't talking back to him. But a lot of us are short in internal disposition. before the Lord, when we come late prostrate before the Lord, or when we get on bended knees before the Lord, oh glory to God, we don't want nobody to see us like that, but the way to go up is to go down.
Amen.
And so now, if I can preach it now.
Yes, sir.
Yourself. Oh, glory to God. What this young man did, he illustrates in the narrative. He runs, he forgets who he was. He run out of self, number, and then he climbed up into the tree. Help me out, Brother B. He runs into the tree. Now, what makes that so significant, buddy, is this. The tree represents the cross. Before the Lord, he'll meet you there. If anybody here wants to meet the Lord this morning, I don't care about all your troubles. I don't care about your stature. I don't care where you've been. All I know, if you seek him, I know where he'll be found. The book says, in order to be made high, you got to come down low. Come to tell somebody while I'm going to heaven that if you humble yourself, Christ will lift you up. If there's anybody here who want to be lifted up, if I be lifted up, I will draw men. Christ will have men to hear words from you, and they'll come and they will seek your God and they will seek the Lord. He can be found. Come to the cross, and Christ will meet you there. Is anybody here? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But first, what you got to do, you have to make a decision that you need the Lord to take you to a higher level in glory. You got to make up in your mind that you need something from the Lord. Anybody in here that needs something from the Lord, I need you to say it. Yeah.
Collector slash publican who's rich, the Bible says. Now, when the book says you're rich, you got to believe he was rich.
Yes.
He heard about Christ because he heard what happened to Levi, Matthew, in earlier situation where Jesus came and dined with Matthew, named Levi. And Levi left everything he had to follow Christ. So word got around that our Christ, our God, is a friend to sinners and publicans.
All right. Yes.
And he wanted to see who Jesus was. But in order to do that, he had to go through
through some things.
Oh, yes.
And he teaches us in this great teaching narrative that in order to see Christ, sometimes you got to go down.
Oh, yes.
And when you go down, that puts you at a level for Christ to lift you up. And when Christ lifts you up, the book says he seats you in heavenly places.
Amen.
If there's more, you have to believe that the more starts with us.
Yes.
We have to go higher. In grace. First, we have to make that decision to change our attitudes. Before God can change our attitudes. We got to go out and find evangelists. I come to tell you, evangelists are already here. We got to go out and search for missionaries. Guess what? Let's look around you. The missionaries are right here. There's young deacons sitting all up in the pulpit, in the pews. Preachers already right here.
That's right.
You hear what I say? Anointed preachers. Just look around. I see you. Y'all don't even want to shake my hand. I see you. Because I tell you. I'm looking at you. I know. Pastor been preaching to you all these years. Sister pastor as well. We got everything we need in Jesus. And you know what? You know I'm talking to you. By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
I'm talking to you right now. You're trying to hold on. You know God wants to deliver you right now. You're biting your nails. You're holding your toes in between. You're twiddling your toes in your feet, your shoes. You're folding your arms. Lord, that's a God. But I call you out now by the power of God. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Oh, Zion.
Yes.
Listen. Before we take communion, I gotta ask, by the power of the Holy Ghost, as an elder in the body of Christ, who am I preaching to? If you heard this word, not just heard this word with your physical ear, but your spiritual ear, I want you to come down to this altar. If you're ready to go to a higher level in grace, I want you to come right now, unashamed, nothing holding you, there's no obstacles right now, nothing but grace, there you go, just begin to kneel, pray right now. I'm at a point in my ministry where enough is enough. God wants to use you now. And I forgot to tell you this part. You know that little man called Zacchaeus, who was a tax collector? Guess what? He became the bishop of Caesarea. Don't tell me what God won't do. What he did for me, he'll do for you. Come on, there's more. You just have to just lift your legs up and say, Lord, I heard the voice of Jesus say, come unto me. I will give you rest. Come on.